last week.
Christine will be last.
Christine will be last.
Yep.
Baby, I see you. And then it's us six. But yeah, us four, Hayden, Derek.
Final six.
Home boys.
Isn't that sick? The final six make the final six. Or boys, the six damn. From the beginning. Well, not from the beginning, but.
Devin doesn't count.
Yeah.
Devin does not count.
You think the vote's gonna be 8-0? Can you talk to Victoria, you two? Not that it matters. I'm not worried. I don't want to like make it feel like I'm like trying to like plead my case or anything.
It's not gonna be 8-0. Donnie's not gonna vote.
Yeah, I don't think so.
I think he is going to, dude.
And I don't know about
Victoria. He didn't do it before. He went against the house before. With her being up there, with Jocasta being up there.
He told me he would vote her out if he needed to. Mm. And I think Donnie likes me.
There you go, then. He might.
He might.
I just don't see him doing it.
I agree with your side, too.
But
I'm not disagreeing with you.
But it won't really matter if it's 7-1. She's leaving.
No, so. It just makes it easier for us.
Yeah. At the end of the day, it's Donnie. If you vote against the house, you'll be next. If you don't win. So, and then I think at that point, he would probably go with Al.
Yep.
I just know there was other times when she was on the block. He didn't care. He voted to keep her here, and didn't matter who it was against.
True. God. I hope it's at double evict, or at least go back, or at least go to single HOH, man.
To what? Single HOH? Me too.
At least.
Oh, my God.
Can you imagine
if we're going to go to single HOH, it has to be a double evict.
Yeah, I agree.
Because if it's not a double evict, then there's still going to be two HOHs, four people on the block.
That's literally...
Everyone.
Everyone.
No, not really, but there's three people that are safe.
Yeah.
Three. Because there's 10 people left in the house, two HOHs, and four nominees. There's four people not on the block. Four. Just us four. I mean, Derek, Hayden, Nicole, Christine are all on the block, and fucking Victoria and... whoever else is HOH. Like, literally.
10?
After Jocasta leaves, there's 10 people left.
I don't think they'll do it again. I don't think they'll do two HOHs again.
We thought that last week when I said... Hold on. Caleb, before I interrupt you, do you remember saying when the memory wall went to head of household, time to get Luby, you said, see how it says head of household. Yeah. Remember? Right? Yeah. But, so you never know, dude.
But we had enough. If they do that, there's no... If they do a double eviction... There's no time for them to do a B.O.B.,
agreed.
HOH,
no,
B.O.B.
No, I agree with that.
No, that's like saying double eviction has to be single HOH.
If it's a double eviction, there will not be a B.O.B. They don't have enough time.
They don't have enough time. No. Exactly, in an episode to do a double evict.
Yeah, there's
no time. Can you imagine if it's double evict, Jocasta, Donnie, and then it's just us six, Christine,
Hayden.
No, Hayden's part of the six.
Oh,
Christine.
Nicole,
Victoria. Christina, how easy is it going to be to get out with Christina before Victoria? We're balling.
Christina. I don't know. Nicole's a tough competitor.
Nicole's not fucking stupid.
No. She's a nurse. She's not dumb.
And
she won HOH. She almost won the POV.
She's won HOH. She's won two HOHs in the state at once.
Yeah.
Like, she's not.
She hasn't won a POV, though. Yes, she has. Has she won a POV?
She's not won a POV.
No. I mean, she's won two HOHs.
Almost did win the POV, though.
Almost. Yeah. That's the thing. It's getting to the time now to where them two, Christine and her, can win the comps because they know they're diehard Big Brother fans and they know what to do. They have strategy.
There's only one other competition that suits well for the diehards before and after. Every other comp is a toss-up, same as anybody else that wants
yeah.
to the show. There's only a before and after that's only going to be the other thing, or a POV, because the number one, when it was a date of something, a day, was a POV. That's not an HOH.
Yeah.
The only other HOH is a before and after.
And I feel like, you know, speaking for myself, I'm just as good at
I've been fucking rattling off everything that they rattle off.
Right.
And so that's my thing is...
The date one is... Yeah.
The day one? What are you talking about?
Like what day did this happen?
What day did...
And you have to roll a ball and Joey try to get it in
the... Joey evicted from the Big Brother house. Like, what day did Devin win the veto?
Yeah.
What day did Devin use the veto?
Oh, I'd lose that comp.
Yeah. What day did Devin use the
veto? I'd lose that. Straight up.
Yep.
I wouldn't even try. Like, it's game over.
Just...
I can't even remember who won first HOH.
You.
You did, Rose.
I know, but still. I mean, that's...
Yeah, I'm just trying to prove a point.
Right.
Yeah, that's how bad my memory is.
You were good with those fucking pictures.
Yeah, but those were the day of. You send me back 7 weeks.
Right.
I slept since then. I've had dreams about my ex. I've had dreams about Amber. I've had dreams about riding horses.
Why am I not surprised?
I've had dreams about Frankie.
Yay!
I mean, I've had dreams since I forget a lot.
I've been having some crazy dreams lately.
Dreams about war. Dreams throw me off, dude.
Did you get, like, PTSD at all?
When I first got home, they said I did. A certain kind, like a certain type, form, but I didn't feel it. No. Just, if I would drink, I'd get a little nuts.
How about dreams?
Yeah.
Waking up, screaming, things like that?
Every now and then. Yeah.
Yikes.
But I was over that in like 6 months.
We're going to have PTBBD after this.
I got to, like when I first got home, that like my dad had to watch me for a year. No, 6 months. The 6 months that I was on that, they were like, you need to watch him close, blah, blah, blah. That was all bogus. I didn't need to be watched. Like, because during all my interviews and all my sessions with the psychs, they pissed me off on purpose.
Yeah.
You know, they'd play this little calm music and, all right, Mr. Reynolds, close your eyes. And I'd close them, and they'd get to talking to me, and then it's like, well, now you're raising your voice, Mr. Reynolds. And I'm like, no, I'm not. And then see, now you're being aggressive. And then it's like, oh, my gosh, you're killing me. Just hurry up with whatever you got to do. Then it's, you know, so then they send you to the next one with a bad note. Ah, he got hostile. Yeah, okay. Hostile is me punching you in the neck and watching you try to take breaths. That's hostile. But it was never that, you know. It was, they made me be like that. So it was all stupid.
I'm sure that's part of their, it's part of the process. That's part of what they're trying to do. They're trying to piss you off.
Yeah, when I got home.
To see how easy you're gonna be pissed off.
During my like demo process, like getting all my shots again and going through all that, we had one psych test and I failed it. But like 7 people failed it.
And then did you have to repass, like did they put you in like holding or something and then you have to repass it or
something? No, I just had to go see extra doctors. And they would like hold my hands to see if I was nervous, like shaking. They'd hold my hands and talk to me, like eye to eye. They were like, the whole time we speak, don't look anywhere else but into my eyes. And then they'd talk to me and ask me questions. Did you see dead bodies? Did you do this? Did you do that? Blah, blah, blah. Do you feel like hurting yourself? Do you feel like hurting someone else? All this stuff.
God.
Yeah. And then it was like suicide prevention. And then it was a bunch of crap.
Yep.
Two weeks of testing, same testing I took before I left, and they were just all different. But it's like, do you expect me to come home being the exact same? Not gonna
happen. No.
But do I feel like going in a rage and hitting people in the face with rocks? No. Like, you know, I'm the same guy. I don't feel like harming nothing. I'm cool. But the testing was proven different. So not really a habit, but certain forms. There's a lot of different forms of PTSD.
Yeah.
Like just being lonely, feeling alone. Is a form of PTSD, feeling, you know, so many different types. So do I have it to where, like my dad has it, to where I just wake up punching the walls and kicking stuff? No. But did I have it to where I felt alone and I would just start crying for no reason? Yeah. Like I'd be in the middle of dinner with my family and just break down.
Mm.
Or in the shower at the gym, just fall down and just start crying for no reason. But... I think the biggest part when I got home is I felt unsafe.
Sure.
Because I felt like no one had my back at that point. Being a year and 2 months overseas, knowing that I was with someone 24/7, I had a guy here and a guy here, and they had my back no matter what. Coming home to going to the gym alone, constantly looking over my shoulder, looking for trash in the streets, stuff like that, driving. You know, a Humvee would only go 30 miles an hour, so when I got home, my driving was all jacked up. But I was paranoid more than anything. Like, because overseas, you see a an old pillow on the side of the road, it's really a bomb, you know. Or you see a trash bag on the side of the road, it's a bomb. Or you see the road raised up a little bit in the middle of the road, you know, you don't drive over it. Just stuff like that. So when you go home, you see trash on the side of the road, you're like you stop a mile back because you're like, okay, you see that trash up there? We don't need to go by it. Like, Caleb, you're home now. Like, it's just trash. But for me, I'm like, it's not just trash. You know, so little stuff like that, but I've been way over that. You know, I don't deal with that stuff anymore. But yeah, when I first got home, it was a little hard.
Yeah.
Yes.
One thing I can relate to is when I was attacked back in when I was in Pennsylvania. Like, it took me, it's been a year now, and I still get scared sometimes. Like, I was scared to do anything.
Yeah,
I was scared to get in my car. I was scared to be alone. I was scared to be in my apartment.
And see,
that
itself can be a form of PTSD.
It absolutely was. It was definitely a form of PTSD.
Yeah. And
absolutely.
And you know, the arguments that come along all the time, the arguments. So how come you get compensated and how come you get paid for having PTSD, but girls that get raped that have it don't get paid? You know what I mean? And for us, you know, for me, I'm going to back up me. You know, I'm going to back up the military. At the same time, I have it due to a way different reason than she has it. I was, you know, the whole form of military guys that are deployed, they're being shot at. They're being blown up. It's a different form.
You're seeing your brothers die in front of you.
Yeah, so it's completely different, you know. Now, should she be treated different? To an extent, but she should still be treated.
There should be like insurance. Like she should be covered under health insurance.
Because that point, you know, that girl's probably scared to death of guys.
Right. She's I don't think she should be covered by the government. I think she'd be covered by health insurance. You know,
and then they become violent, and then they, you know.
Yeah. So, you know, there's so many different forms. You know, like my brothers now, you know, they can look back and be like, you know, no, you're not different to me. And in a way, it pisses me off. But when they say when you first got home, you were completely different. But now I think you're back to where, you know, you started. So.
And they wouldn't have let you on the show if you had any.
Yeah, no, not at all.
No. But
that's what I mean by now I'm fine. But, you know, like I wasn't hired. Like I couldn't be hired at any job. Just stuff like that. But like if I wanted to be compensated and get paid for PTSD to a certain point, I could. Because I failed that test when I first got home, and that's all it would take. But, you know, I'm fine. Like, I don't need to be paid for that, you know? Now my vision, my hearing is jacked up because
seriously, yeah, from the bombs?
Yeah, bombs, any of that kind of stuff. Shooting 50 cals without earplugs in, all that sort of stuff. I'm dang near deaf in my left ear. It was fun, though, while it lasted. Reynolds, huh? Looking down, I'm like, what? I just had to read their mouth because it was wee. That was dumb.
That you shot without earplugs, or that it was
that specific weapon? Yeah.
Did you shoot? Oh, but you're saying that it was dumb that you did that?
It was dumb that I shot it without earplugs.
But you didn't have time to put earplugs in.
Didn't have time.
Reynolds,
it was in combat.
Yeah, mile
after years. No fucking way.
Yeah.
It was in combat.
Yep.
Yeah. It wasn't like a training mission?
I'm sitting down. No, a training mission, they make sure you put them in. Like, they make you put them in before you even enter anything for practice. Sitting in the back seat, chilling. All of a sudden, this guy happens to whatever. And then, Reynolds, drop on the 50. Okay.
This guy
and talking to me, and I'm like,
to
what?
Whatever. Like, so, like somebody up in a building was shooting at
him? No, someone else was in the gunner hatch. Man in the 50 cal.
Right. Oh,
and then there was a time he could not man it anymore. So then I was the next person in line to get on it.
Jesus.
So I had to get on it. And
do you know, can you say what kind of situation you were in?
Just hostile. And not a good one. Not a good situation. But that at that point, I thought I will never hear anything again. So I couldn't hear. Everything was muffled.
Yeah.
I could hear someone, you know, speaking to me, but I couldn't hear what they were. It was like, and I was like.
You know when they do that in movies? It freaks me the fuck out.
Yeah, it's... Like, I was scared. Like, I was like, I just ruined my... That's the only thing I think of. I can't hear nothing. I'm screwed.
Like, what movie do they do that in? After Earth? Did you guys see After Earth with Will Smith?
Will Smith,
you know,
and
like,
his
when
son.
They wake up and it's like...
Yeah.
My ears.
That's what it's like. That's what it's like if the IED, you know, blows up.
Yep.
Mm-hmm. That's what it's like.
My ear's been like that for 7 years.
From the accident? Mm-hmm. Are you serious? No.
From a lacrosse ball. A lacrosse ball hit me 110 miles an hour in the eardrum, perforated my eardrum, broke everything inside my ear.
Oh, that's why you had to have surgery?
Yeah, I had surgery on my ear, and my ear has constantly been ringing since it's happened. And I've gone to like numerous ear, nose, and throat. They're like, honestly, there's nothing we can do about it, and you're just screwed.
Your ear was ringing right now?
Yeah, it rings every second of every day, doesn't stop.
It's crazy.
And when things get really quiet, like when we're in the fire room, like waiting for the HOH, waiting for the nominations the other day, it was so bad. It's literally ringing right now, every second of every single day. And as I'm talking about it now, it's getting higher.
It's crazy. My brother.
There's nothing I can do about it, though.
My brother boxed. Like,
you
should
go to get 75 more opinions.
That's nuts. My brother busted his ear.
Technology gets better every single year. Every single year. Might be able to fix it.
I just got over it. I just get over it. I've just learned to. And I'm like 30% deaf in my ear, too. I've had ear tests. They're just like, yeah.
I have H3. H3 hearing.
What's that mean?
H3, close to deaf. In my left ear.
Mine's my left also.
Yeah. Certain sounds I can't hear with this, like higher pitch I can't hear.
When I talk on the phone in my right ear, and then I talk on my phone in my left ear, it's like so different. And like, especially when I'm listening to my earphones, like if I just have my right ear, it's like perfect. Put my left ear. And then when I talk on the phone in my right ear, every time like someone talks and like noises go through my ear, like my eardrum goes. It's the weirdest thing. I've tried eardrops. The doctor even said like honestly like.
Well, the ear is a fucked up system. Do you understand what it is? Like the anvil, the hammer, the fucking drum. It's the most complicated motherfucking thing in our body.
Fucked. I'm so
it's
fucked.
Crazy.
It's called
I'm just trying to get over it, though.
The anvil and the stirrup. There's three parts. I don't remember.
They had to cut the back of my ear. I have a scar from like here to here. They cut my ear off. They just fold it over. So, like, literally, they're looking inside my...
You're, like, face-off. Like, what the hell? Your entire face has been removed, like, six times.
Two ACLs, ear, eye...
Nose.
Everything. My mom, like, makes fun of me. She's like, you're fucking ridiculous. Like, but I'm also blessed in other ways, you know? So, like, you know, things like that happen for reason. Like, I've had two knee surgeries.
But you're fine. You can still go kick a ball.
Yeah. And not only that, but it was God telling me, yo, you're meant to play golf. Like, stop trying to dunk the basketball. Like, yeah, you can jump really high, but you're not meant to do that. Yeah, you're really fast, but you're not meant to play football, you know? Yeah, you're good at lacrosse, but don't play lacrosse. It's not just golf. Just play golf.
Heard that.
And now my little broski's a fucking boss-ass golfer. He's going to be a pro golfer. He's going to make tons of millions of dollars playing golf just because I had two ACL surgeries. You know? Just gotta look at the positives. I'm lucky. I'm lucky I'm not in a wheelchair. I'm lucky I can see and hear and don't take things for granted, you know?
Dude, I would die for a letter from my mom.
You'll get it. You can get it. You can get it this week.
I don't really care about pictures. I remember what she looks like. But a letter of her writing something to me,
dude.
It will take me back to Iraq and basic training.
Nothing made me happy.
You could only get physical letters, right? Huh? They wouldn't let you get emails or anything?
I got to Skype on occasion.
But email?
Email? I didn't email much. Facebook.
But you could do that?
Yeah. Yep. 30,000 miles away.
30,000 miles away.
You always love you more when you're miles away. Huh? I always love you more when you're miles away.
Was it like something Iraq? Like
Baghdad.
Wow.
Yep. Dead center.
Baghdad.
Yep. Yep.
And you flew there in like a military 747? Or like?
I flew to Ireland in a commercial. And then from there to Kuwait, it was a C-17. Military grade.
Cargo ship.
Yep. And then when we entered Kuwait, we had to fly down in a circle like this and all of us about threw up. You have to fly like this so no one shoots your plane down.
Are you fucking serious?
Yeah. If you just flying straight like that, you're a target. They can lock in on you. When you're doing like this, circles, they can't lock in on you, so that's how you have to land.
So you, like this the whole way?
Yeah.
Like a tornado?
Yeah, and you feel it. That's how you're flying when you're landing. And
do they tell you that you're about to do that?
I can't remember if they told us or not. I don't think so.
That would make me throw up for sure.
Yeah,
plane was just like this the whole time.
Yeah, until we touched the ground. Yep. In a huge aircraft. The wings were longer than this backyard. C-17. They're massive cargo planes.
So we were deep in war at that point, yeah?
What year did you go?
You were clean up
2009. Crew? Huh?
Were you cleaning it up or were you...
No, we weren't cleaning up just yet when I was there. We, certain tanks and stuff that we didn't need anymore, they were cleaning up, sending back. But as far as equipment and stuff, we weren't cleaning up just yet. We were still in the process of turning over, like, the prisons over to the ICOs.
Okay.
To the government. My deployment was actually one of the biggest years of the war because we finally transferred. We gave them their hand back in what they did. Like, we were running everything.
Like, you took over it, and then we're like, here. After they took the statue down?
We took over the prison and stuff to show them how to run it. And then when we were done showing them, they got it. Then we gave them the key back and said, here's your prison back.
Mm.
And then.